Oklahoma City tomorrow. Without Kevin Durant, Westbrook is is putting his team on his shoulders and saying, come on, y'all, let's go. Anytime you got players like that, the Mavericks do not match up well with hard-hitting players like that. James Harden kills them all the time.
He does.
Westbrook kills them all the time.
Steph Curry
kills them all the time. You cannot just stand up toe-to-toe with players like that.
And what baffles me is we got a roster that could easily win 60 games.
It could 2 or 3 years ago. See, that's what we need to – see, we fell in love with the name.
We got talent on this team.
No, we fell in love with the name. The name is what we fell in love with.
The name of what?
The name Amari Stoudemire. We fell in love with the name. Rajon Rondo.
Talent.
We still fell in love with the name.
He has talent.
Used to.
There's no used to. They still do.
Then why are we not playing? Why are we not playing like we got talent?
It's the camera. It's trying to mix oil and water, and it's not mixing. It's the chemistry. We got ball players on this team. Golden State, they don't have the names, but their chemistry is off the chain.
Their chemistry is off the chain.
It's off the chain.
Yeah.
And they don't have superstar-studded players, not as many as the Mavs. The Mavs have almost 10 All-Stars on their team, meaning that at least one player on their team has been to an All-Star game one time in his career.
You're right.
Devin Harris, Dirk Nowitzki, Amari Stoudemire,
Rajon Rondo. Yeah, you're right.
Now, Monte Ellis should have been an All-Star, but he has yet to appear in one.
But should have, can't, ain't working.
You got
Chandler Parsons.
Has he been to an All-Star game?
I think so, yeah. He was the star pickup this year. I think last year he went to All-Star. We got players. The problem is are the Eagles too big for them?
Carlisle have said that he's done what he could do.
And when your coach throw his hands up, what do?
You in trouble.
You
in trouble.
It's one and done. When the coach says, man, I can't go no further.
I think it's Carlisle's fault.
I'm not saying it's Carlisle's fault. It's that these guys right here just need to learn how to play together. The problem is, do you have time to learn?
So let me ask you this. Donnie Nelson was responsible for bringing Rondo here to Dallas. Do you think that was a mistake? He's a talent evaluator.
Who do we have if we didn't bring him there? Jeffries?
We had Jameer Nelson.
Jameer Nelson. Who do we have? Like I said.
And again, it's funny how
the
offense flowed when he was the starting point guard.
Yeah, but defense wasn't doing jack.
He's not a good defensive point guard. And the reason why they brought Rondo here is for his defense.
And guess what? The Mavericks defense is good. The problem is this right here. Their scoring percentages are just crappy. When you score 38 points in the second half, you're crappy.
Very crappy.
What I don't understand, and all you did was take away one player. That's all you did. But maybe the problem is that their shot selection is bad. And maybe we're not putting – maybe Rajon Rondo is not putting the players in the places they're supposed to hit the shot.
Wow.
You know, maybe our quarterback is throwing ducks.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not throwing them shots that he's supposed to throw. Maybe he's just sitting out there just trying to, you know, be Boston Rajon Rondo, and this ain't in Boston. We in Dallas.
That's a pure point guard, but now are we saying that he's a point guard for a certain offense and not all offenses?
I think so. The problem is we'd already set our offense up before he got here. Now we got to change up everything when he gets here because he can't play this offense.
What's the one difference between Rondo and Kidd?
Kidd knew where the players were supposed to be. Kidd knew exactly where you're supposed to be.
And he wasn't as – I don't think he was as careless with the –
He wasn't that – no, he was more careful than anything else. He didn't – see, Rajon Rondo goes down and throws.
Mm-hmm.
Kidd – and Rondo does a he goes down like a fast break. He's a fast break type of point guard.
Mm-hmm.
Kidd was not a fast break. He could do – he could run a fast break, mm-hmm. but he was not a fast break. He was a let me put it at my pace type point guard.
Mm-hmm.
Rondo says, y'all catch up with me. But the problem is, by the time I get down the floor, my backup ain't here, or my backup doesn't know what I'm doing. So they're not staying ready. They hadn't had time to practice this. Oh, he's going to put it somewhere. Mm-hmm. So stay ready.
Mm-hmm.
With Kidd here, Kidd was running the practice. Kidd was a coach on the floor. Rajon Rondo is not a coach on the floor. Rondo is a player on the floor. He's not a coach.
Right.
If you're going to play that point, you better learn how to coach.
You better learn how to coach.
And right. Rondo is not coaching. He's just playing.
Hmm.
And while he was in Boston, it worked for him because they had time to learn who he was. It takes more than a year, I guess, to learn who he is.
The stats against the Pacers, 17 points, 10 assists, 7 rebounds, 2 steals, and even a block.
Yeah.
This is without Monte in the lineup.
But you just said it. Is it because it was without Monte? Is there a beef between Monte and Roger?
I don't think so. It's just, I don't know. It's when Monte scores 30-plus, Rondo probably barely scores 4 or 5
disappears.
Points.
Not around. Does he play?
So the begging question is, who would you rather have over the other? You let Rondo go and Monte stay, or let Monte go and let Rondo stay?
Say they won with Monte.
If you ask me, Monte is staying.
Yeah, they got a ring with Monte.
What ring?
No, I'm sorry. No, he came after that. But they won. They still won with Monte.
Yes, they did. Monte's more aggressive. He can shoot the ball. He might not pass as crafty as Rondo.
Yeah, but Monte ain't scared to go in the hole.
Monte's a better shooter than Rondo.
He is not scared.
He goes to the hole harder than Rondo.
Yeah. And Rondo.
And he can hit that last shot at the end of the game.
Exactly. And Rondo can't hit that shot. And there's times I was watching, I said, please don't let him shoot. I was actually saying, no, don't shoot. And he'll throw something. I was like, yeah, dog. And the other thing is they don't rebound at all. The Mavericks are a sorry rebounding team.
And Rondo was here to rebound the
but you can't rebound the shot you throw up. You can't throw it up and get your own rebound. There's too many people under the basket.
Yeah, I don't know.
Now, speaking of rebound, though, Dirk is one of the top rebounders in the NFL, in NBA history.
Can you believe that?
I cannot believe it.
I kind of seen that stuff. I thought I was dreaming when I seen that.
He's in a company with, as far as most points, rebounds, and it was another one he had. He's in the top three. Will Chamberlain and Jordan is in that same company as far as rebounds and points.
Well, being in the league for 16 years would do it too.
Well, yeah, no, because.
I mean, the man been starting for 16
Kareem,
years.
Kareem is not in there.
Wait a minute.
Kareem is not on that list.
He was a center. He's not on the list.
Right.
Ain't been in NBA for over 20 years.
Yeah. Kareem ain't on that list.
Man, you're going to have to share that list.
I'm about to share that list with y'all.
You mean to tell me that Dirk Nowitzki has more rebounds than Kareem?
Well, No. What I'm saying is the combination of rebounds, points, and there's another. Yeah, it's another stat.
I can see that.
Yes, another stat. There's a combination that they have where only three hit that list.
And Dirk was one of them.
Dirk is one of them.
Wow.
Dirk, Wilt Chamberlain, and Jordan.
Wilt Chamberlain, Jordan.
Yeah, well, you know Jordan going to go up and get anything.
With Jordan.
Jordan going to go up and get anything.
I mean, it does surprise me considering.
But see, you're thinking just rebounds.
Yeah.
I'm talking about points. Over 10,000 and that the whole
over 30,000 points and 10,000 rebounds?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I'm thinking about those two, that list. How many points you have and how many rebounds you have. That's a combination. So you got Kareem that might give you 20,000 rebounds and he ain't going to give you 30,000 points. Wilt is going to give you both rebounds and points. You know, speaking of that, we got a trivia question. You want to give him a trivia question before we go pay a bill?
Actually, yes, sir. And that trivia question is, drum roll. The trivia question is,
okay, I'll tell you.
What is the name of the last FBS or FCS school to win 4 NCAA football titles in a row? Bonus. What years?
Football. No, basketball. That should be basketball.
What is the name of the last FBS or FCS school to win 4 NCAA football titles in a row?
Okay.
Bonus. In what years?
Well, I know the answer.
Of course you do.
It wasn't this year.
Don't start that. Y'all, we got to pay some bills. You're listening to 411 Sports Talk Radio on FaceTimeRadio.com. Don't forget to go to our website, 411SportsNews.com. If you want to go to the website and go to the poll question we had about the five quarterbacks, you will go to the website, click on Entertainment, and click on Talk Radio, scroll to the bottom, and vote. Okay?
There you go.
Pay some bills.
All right.
We'll be right back.
Yeah, that was some LL Cool J.
That's some old school LL Cool J.
Yeah.
Okay,
I was still mixing. Yeah. We know Cool J. We know it's you.
We know it's you, bro.
Yeah, come you on. Ain't got to tell us again.
Welcome back to 411 Sports Talk Radio on FaceTimeRadio.com. Our website is 411SportsNews.com. Continue our talk with the Mavericks. Right now, they are 45-29. They are 7th place in the West, 3 games ahead of OKC for the 8th seed. The Mavericks' magic number is 3.
Can it get there?
Yes. With 3, magic number is 3 with, I think it's 9
games
to go.
They got 9 to play, yeah.
If the Mavericks... get to that magic number 3, it's an automatic that they'll be in the playoffs.
Right.
For them to not be in the playoffs, Oklahoma City will have to